I am sorry. We had some technical issues and I don't know what's going on, but Candace was supposed to be here with me. And the way the system operates, if the person you're interviewing or the person in the video with you doesn't log in, it won't let either one of you. So I couldn't even come on to tell you that I wouldn't be here. And I apologize for that. But I created a new one real quick by myself, and you can ask questions down below, and I'm going to tell you about what's coming up because we have. I keep looking down because my screen's down here. Hey, David, what's going on, brother? Thanks for talking to me here. I'm glad somebody's watching. Anyway, I have scheduled several weeks out of vendors to do live interviews when it's available for them. So, I've scheduled those out. I may have to change a few things because if they don't show up at the time, Facebook lets the thing sit there and run for 10 minutes. And if they don't show up, it shuts it off. Hey, David, it just shuts it off. So I can't even broadcast to you if they didn't show up. It just waits for them, waits for them, waits for them. And it just times down 10 minutes. Hey, Terry, Shane says hi. Ellis says hi. Jim says hi. Darude, thanks for the videos. You're welcome, brother. Skip says hi. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I've got a new system I'm trying out, and with the system, it puts your messages up on the screen for me. And watch this. Watch this. I can say, hey, Alex, I can post up on the screen somebody's message. Thanks for the video. So if you have a question today, I'd be happy to answer it. Okay? I'll post up your question. I'll do my best to answer it for you and we'll move on. I apologize that the interview didn't work. What it does is it splits the screen and two people are able to do a live simultaneous broadcast to the screen that you're watching, and then we can both help you and answer your questions. Fantastic plan. If my interviewee would have showed up. I don't know what happened. And Mike, thanks for being here. I'm glad you're here. So, I don't know how to take these off yet. There we go. I took that one off. But if I don't have any questions here, what I'm going to do is tell you that we are going to be interviewing some vendors all across the world. I've already set up a bunch. And you'll get notifications here on this page if you sign up to the notifications at the top of the page. And what will happen is you'll be notified and updated when it goes live. Okay, it always will tell you when it's supposed to be live, like today, but then it didn't happen. So I apologize. The other thing is, I don't whether you are in the business yet or not. We have a website that it and a lot of you already know about it, but learnhotdogs.com. You can go over there and post in stuff. Watch this real quick. I can actually type on the screen learnhotdogs.com and I can show that to you. We are live, supposedly. So I it should on the screen be this learnhotdogs.com. I can't see it on mine. I can only see yours. So what we'll do though is I will continue to do these, but we're trying this new thing. David says yuppers. Good. Michael Wood, hi, Michael. If I'd have set this up in the right way, probably I probably should have a backup guest. That way, if one doesn't show up, the other one's there. Because I don't like how that did to me. It would not let me start the show because the other person wasn't there. So it messed us up. Greg Crafton says hi. Terry says it is there. Thank you. Thanks for letting me know. I'm taking that down. Learnhotdogs.com is an awesome place to get all kinds of information you want. I just took it down, Owen. Anyway, if you go over there and there's a search box. We're updating the search box. It'll be on the right-hand side of the screen when you're on the page. And it will, it, you type in any word, type in catering, type in whatever you want, type in steam pans, type in steam, type in mustard. We have something on it. And it's free. It's free information. It helps you grow your business. How much is a good price to rent out carts for a birthday? Hold on just a second. Let's see if I can get that one to show up. Check that out. Timmy asks, don't you love that? Shows up on the screen. How much is a good price to rent out carts for birthday parties, family reunions, and corporate events? Great question. There's so many variables there, okay? So many variables that it would take me a while to explain. And the variables are how many people are coming? What are you serving? What are you doing? Are you taking it? Are they taking it? Are they picking it up from you? Are you doing drop-off catering? Are you taking it and cooking it and serving it? Do you have to supply the napkins and the drinks? There's so many variables, but I cover this. I cover this. I have a article and a video on how to price catering gigs. It's at learnhotdogs.com. It's free. Check it out. Mark says hi. Mark, it only gave me 10 minutes, and by the time I got you a message, it had already run. The time had run out. Once I figured out she wasn't going to be here, I tried to get a hold of you because I knew you had asked. And but we are going to be interviewing Mark soon. Mark Lawler is on here. You'll see him in the chat thing or the comments. We're going to have him on, interview him, talk to him. And if you were in the Vendors United group, okay, you would see stuff that Mark's already done. He does some cool videos, shows you all kinds of stuff, how he operates. Timmy, I wish that I could, it would take longer to explain all I call them idiosyncrasies, the variables that rely on forming a price. But it's not that hard. It's just a lot of information you got to take in. You'd want to write it down, but I'll have it already for you at learnhotdogs.com and .com, how to price your stuff. I'm going to answer some other questions real quick. Let me see here. I'm going to hide this one. That takes it off the screen, supposedly. I'm designing here. I'll show you the thing. Terry says, I'm designing signage for my cart. Can you recommend any sign companies to make actual signs? Yes. There's tons of them. Staples does. Somebody just mentioned Owen. Owen, thank you, Owen. Mentioned Staples. Staples does a good job on signage, and they're quicker because they're right in your backyard. But you can find a sign company in your town. They will probably cut you a deal and make them even cheaper than Staples. But what's the place people get business? Vista Prints. Vista, Vista, Prints. Vistaprints.com. They do business cards, for $500 for $4 or something, and they do signs. And they have a designer online, so you can design it. They'll design it for you. You can do it, use their online design tool. You can create anything you want, upload your logo, whatever you want, make your fonts different, prices bigger, whatever. They are a good one to use, and I've used them probably 600 or 700 times over the years. So great question. I hope that helps you. I always like going to local businesses if I can, but usually somebody like Vistaprint is cheaper by far, typically, even way cheaper than Staples. But I've used Staples. I've had to go to Staples, need something now, they'll do it now. Staples pretty quick. Any tips on getting more catering gigs? Absolutely. John, I just did a live broadcast, a live broadcast on catering. It was a full master class. Okay, it's free. If you need it, email me and I'll get it to you, Ben at hotdogcartstore.com, and I'll just say send me the link, and I'll send you the link. It's going to be taken down because it's going to be a pay course, but right now it's free. And you can watch it. It's a full course and you can watch it. But I am turning it into a pay course. There are tons of ways to get catering gigs, tons, and cool ways to do it and do it quick. I can show you how to do it instantly without spending a dime. And that was something I taught in the masterclass that I've never divulged to anybody other than people that paid me for a private consultation. So, yes. I'm double checking questions. Okay. So bear with me. I want to make sure I don't miss any. Thank y'all for being here. This is cool. Terry and Owen and David and Michael and Mike and Davis and Alex. Thank you. I'm making sure I've covered the, hey, thank you, Timmy. I'm making sure I've covered questions. Let's see. Designing signage. Next one. I need a good soda supply. Can you do boiled peanuts? Let me pull this up. Okay. I need a good soda supply, and can you do boiled peanuts on a cart? You can do about anything on a cart. Boiling the peanuts, as far as boiling peanuts, takes a long time. And I'm sure you may know, Ellis, but I grew up in Peanutville. Okay. And I know, that's one of my favorite snacks. If there's a roadside guy doing peanuts, I'm there, especially the Cajun ones, the hot ones, and hot green boiled. Okay. Green boiled peanuts. But I will tell you this, you'll want to have those already done, even if they're cold, and then put them in your hot boiling water so that you're not doing the whole process from the cart. Takes too long, not enough space. You've seen those big, huge 5-gallon boilers they boil those with. You could add one of those to the cart. I built a cart once. Keith did. And it's a big, it had double boilers. And he had stages for it. So this one would boil them. That's a long process to boil a peanut. So great question though. Now a good soda supply, Ellis asks, a good soda supply. I need to take a sip of my drink or I'm going to, cough. I'm going to cough anyway. So there you go. So I apologize. Well, they went down the wrong pipe. Here I am trying to prevent my dry throat and made myself even cough. Ellis, good soda supply. I teach this in my free training at learnhotdogs.com. At the top, click free training. It's one of the first two or three videos, or maybe it's the fourth video, where to get soda. what I do there is I have found, unless you're buying thousands of sodas, thousands and thousands, it is oftentimes cheaper to go to the grocery store. They get the best deals. And you can go to the grocery store and talk to the manager and say, listen, we're a local business. We have a tax number, sales tax ID, and they will sell you with no tax, number one. My grocery store, Food Line, Food City, both gave me a 10% discount. So what I did is I go to whichever store was having a sale on Pepsi or Coke products, buy a bunch of it, check your dates, make sure it's going to stay in date good and that you have a place to store it. And I'd buy bunches of it and I'd go out. Sometimes I didn't need bunches. Sometimes I just wanted a bunch. I was going to do an auction one time in Cosby, and it's a little town near us. And they were doing this estate sale, and they had requested I got root beer. Went to Food City, which is one of our local grocery stores, and went to Food City and got the root beer and flats and cans and got 10% off plus no tax because I'm collecting tax on my cart. I hope that answers your question, Ellis. Next question. What about renting a cart by itself? I don't know what you mean, Kenny. As far as, are you saying, can you just rent a cart? Or are you saying, can I rent my cart out, just the cart? I covered this in that new, the course I was just talking about, the masterclass I just did. You'll find it down the page. It is, if you just search in the box up here at the top for masterclass right here on Facebook, not your very top bar, but in this search in this group, okay, in this page. It'll say, just type in the word master. It'll pull up the link I did. If you go now, you'll be able to watch that for free. I cover how to rent your cart and you never touch it. You just rent the cart, okay? I cover it all for you. I give you everything you could imagine. I cover stuff you wouldn't even think of, I wouldn't have thought of. And so I give you all the pros and cons of doing things and how to never touch the cart. I show how to make $9,000 and never touch the cart. ever. You don't even see the cart. Some cool ways to make money there. So check that out. I hope that helped you, Kenny. If I didn't, if that wasn't your question, repost it and I'll catch it. High prices at Staples. Yes. Usually pretty high at Staples. Any tips on getting more catering gigs? I think I did that one. I left a voicemail, but a city is saying that I can only vend in their town for 3 days straight under special event permit and four times a year with a 30-day in between vending. Oh, let me just show this. Okay. In between vending with, any thoughts? I read /liar, but didn't help. No, that article really wouldn't help you. That article, well, you know, if you read that article, it's for something completely different. It's when your health department or somebody tells you something that sounds fishy, right? Here's what I want you to do. It's probably true your city has some kind of stupid code, okay? That doesn't mean it's legal. I showed you how to make that legal, how to get rid of that code, okay? Jason just did it this last fall. It took basically a day to take a letter that he sent to the city attorney, to city manager, who gave it to the city attorney. City attorney calls and goes, okay, yeah, we didn't realize we were violating your federal constitutional rights by limiting when you can vend in our town. I have an article on it, tell you everything you need to know. EJ, all you got to do is go to learnhotdogs.com, over on the search box, type in the word. Here's a trick, just to give you all a trick. Any website you want to search, put it in Google, put it in the Google search box, put learnhotdogs.com. Okay. And then I'm going to show you what happens. You put learnhotdogs.com, skip a space, and then whatever search word you want. Google will go into our site or anybody's site and find those answers for you and give you a page with all the articles that we may have talked about it. Okay. So it saves you time in searching. So if you'll do that, but search the word justice, EJ. Go to the site, search the word justice, J-U-S-T-I-C-E. I've got multiple articles there. They'll all help you, but because we rehash stuff a lot, you know, but we get the same question 3 months later and we just talk about it again and we explain it again. So you might get multiple things, but check it all out. The letter, how to get the letter, how to do it all without costing you a dime, and even have an attorney. We even give you the contact for an attorney who will back you up for free. You can't beat that, okay? You don't have to pay nothing. It's kind of like the ACLU for business owners. You know, ACLU is private. You know, it's a nonprofit group who you give money to, and they protect people's civil liberties under the Constitution. This one we give you, the Institute for Justice, they do the same thing, but for businesses. It's awesome. William says, I'll show this. William says, soda at local grocers are the best deals. Absolutely. I would like that course too. Alex Streeter says he'd like the course. I tell you what, I think Heather's on here. If you are, Heather, if you post the link to the show I did on the expanding your business, the catering show. It's about an hour and a half long. It's long, but and you'll want a piece of paper. I swear to you, take a piece of paper and a pen, maybe 5-6 sheets of paper, because I give you so much freaking information, it'll blow your noggin. It's stuff I've never, ever released like that out to everybody. It's going to be a paid course soon. Real soon. So you may want to grab it while it's free. Hot Dog Dave's in the house. David, Timmy, that's David Rambo. How you doing? Let's see. Timmy says, thank you, Ben. Thank you, Timmy. Corey says, hey, everybody. Look at that. I love popping this up. Let's see. EJ, you'll have to have a kitchen in the city. Sometimes. Nope. It's not necessarily have to have a kitchen in the city. They, as long as you have a kitchen that is within distance. You can't be in Texas saying, I got a kitchen in Wisconsin. But your kitchen can be wherever your kitchen is, as long as it's a legitimate distance, okay, to your work, even if you're out of the county or even out of the state. Boss Dogs and George is in the house. Love it. Let's see. Love what you do for everyone. Someday my dreams to join your ranks once the finances allow me. Chris, I understand. And I'm not trying to just blow your noodles today, but I have a course on how to start with little to no money. Okay. And it's dirt cheap. Okay. Go to the blog, learnhotdogs.com. It'll probably pop up at the bottom of the page about 10 seconds after you're there. A little bar will pop up and say, how do you get started with little to no money? Grab that, learnhotdogs.com. And in fact, I'm giving a bonus in that. And I just started it yesterday, day before yesterday. A bonus in it that nobody's seen, nobody. Okay. That only those people get it that are getting that course now. It's inexpensive as heck, but the bonus comes free and you won't have to worry about anything. And you'll get a bonus that's going to be, later it'll be a pay course on my site, kind of like the catering one. Let's see. How about Restaurant Depot? Yes, you can buy sodas at Restaurant Depot and all those places. You can buy sodas at Sam's Club. You can even call a distributor. If you were in Vendors United group right now, Corey just posted up a video talking about how he got a good deal through his distributor. He gives a secret on how to get a good deal through the Coke or Pepsi distributor. Okay, let's see. I live in, let me pull this up just to make sure. Oh, he's just responding to somebody else. Okay, awesome. That's what I'm looking for. Here's the master class. Oh, Heather posted up the master class link. It's at the 16:27 second mark. She posted it up. I'm going to show you right here. I'm catering a spaghetti lunch tomorrow. Kick butt, Mark. Kick butt. Mark's going to be on here. Y'all wait. Next week, I believe Mark comes on and he's going to be on here with me. We're going to have some fun. We're going to ask some questions. Mark is kick butt. Wait till y'all see how he inspires you and what he's done with his business. Corey's even on here. Holy cow. We got Corey. Okay. Cater to a taco. I'm going through these things. Just ignore me. Oh. Heather, fix the search box at learnhotdogs.com because me, this guy right here, went in there and deleted it accidentally. Today, I was doing some touch-ups and deleted it, and couldn't figure out how to get it back. So it's back. That's why I gave you all the Google search reference. Jill said, Jill's talk, I don't know. Oh, Jill's talking about some deal she did. Okay, cool. I think I got everybody's questions. I hope you enjoyed this. I do. I hope it was worth your money. And I've had fun. Now, I'm gonna send you off with this one little thing. I can't tell how many people are here. I hope a bunch. And even if there's not, I hope it helps you. Not you, you. All right. Here's the deal. Ken, thank you, Ken. I want to send you off with this, okay? And this is, I'm not some guru, make your head big thing, but I want you to think about this. I get calls and now it's getting busier and busy. Tony, Alexis, Heather, see if you can help him with the Vendors United. Alexis said, or I said Alexis. It is Alexis. 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 I apologize. I don't know what the deal is. This thing's rolling on me like this, and so I keep having to stop it. When I'm in Vendors United, can't see the new info. It's there. You may have to refresh, but we can help you with that. Support at vendorsunited.com. They can solve it. And Heather will help you there. Okay, here's what I want to send you off with. I know I've kept you, and I apologize. I want to send you off with an idea. I get calls, okay, from people, and they give me 900 reasons why they can't do something. And my wife's dad, he's pretty old. He's 88, okay? And he's pretty freaking old. He was telling me about growing up in Ohio, and then this was just the other day, this weekend, and he was telling me about working, and he was a soda delivery guy. He delivered soda, and that was back when they put it in the hey Scott, Michael, how y'all doing? They put it into the a glass bottle. It wasn't plastic bottles and cans. That was all glass, right? Well, he's up north, okay? And he's delivering in this, old metal-sided truck, no insulation thing in the winter. And they had to deliver to all their locations. And his little area covered about 300 miles, okay? So he had to do one section one day, another section another day, going to different stores, delivering soda, right? And so he's delivering all these sodas, and they used to keep in the truck a fire going, a fire in the truck to keep the sodas from busting from the cold weather. Because back then, no heater in the back of the truck. It was just in the front, and he said it was piss poor at the front. So he had heat. And I was thinking about this. I was going, my gosh. We take for granted so much stuff. We take for granted all the extra things. I get mad that I have to swipe twice to get to my Facebook message, or whatever. The little things that piss us off daily that we don't realize are taking up our time and taking up our positive energy. When and here my father-in-law was delivering soda, breathing in smoke, okay? Because he said his cab had a sliding door, but you still, it smelled up. The whole reason he told me the story, it was not to tell me how bad he had it. It was about the time he caught the truck on fire because his can of charcoal tipped over. So they would burn wood outside, get it to charcoal status, put it inside, keep the truck warm. And they kept having to rotate that stuff. And every now and then, if it was a long trip, they had to add more wood to it. Well, he had added more wood, more than just charcoal going. He had a little fire going in his can and sitting in the back of this truck. And it's a covered metal truck, And he makes a turn anyway, flips it over. Okay. Doesn't realize he flipped it over because he's got the door shut behind him, the little sliding door. Goes and pulls up to a store and goes in to see how many sodas they need and exchange stuff out, right? And he goes in, and the lady in running the store starts hollering at him, "Oh my gosh, Charlie, the freaking truck's on fire." And the whole truck went up in smoke because all the sides of the inside of the truck was wood and the floor was wood. And it got me thinking of just how easy it is to get wrapped up in our stuff. And it's not that our stuff isn't important. It's just, it gives you an insight how much easier we have it. We have the ability to go out there today. You have the ability to go out there today and make money. There's people listening right now that do it every day with a card. Okay. Corey was just on here. Corey, well, I think he still is. Corey started with a home built card. Okay. Home built card. Moves up, gets him a concession cart trailer, decks it out the way he wants, just a small one. I'm talking small. It had hardly enough room to change your mind in. Then now has a restaurant, has a cater pro, has all this stuff, and he's got it going on. And you go, well, he's probably been doing it 25 years. No, he's only 5 years, 4 or 5 years, I think Corey has been doing it. There's a value, there's a benefit. And knowing that you can go out there and make a good income, make a living, work not full time unless you want to. You pick your days, and the more better good are you are at keeping records. I have a free thing on that too. I'll double your income by pulling your records. If you keep good records, you'll double your income. Period. Because you'll know, oh, Thursdays in front of the Tomahawk store sucks. I'm gonna quit going there on Thursdays. Or the third Thursday of every month is really good. That's where I'm gonna go. I'm gonna be at, whatever store. If you keep records, you do that stuff, you'll be able to limit how much you work down to a very small fraction. People like Michael Woods, a lot of people on here do it. They know, they figured this out. Okay? You can too. I wish y'all well. I'm sorry the interview didn't happen. I apologize profusely. We have more coming. Stand by for those. There'll be announcements here on the page. I love you all. If I can help you in the future, holler at me. You can go to learnhotdogs.com/ask Ben or just click the button on the Learn Hot Dogs thing and I'll help you as much as I can. And I hope that it, that John just posted 1,000 a month, 2 days a week in College Town. Heck yeah, John. And probably there's ways to increase that. We even showed you ways to not spend any more time and increase your income. And that's why I did that free class the other day, the master class. And Heather's got the links in the comments here somewhere. So I love you guys. I hope y'all have a fantastic day. Thanks for coming. I'll see you soon. Oh, I'll be back tomorrow at 3:30. We're doing the normal Friday show, the Q&A. See you later.